Thomas in Turkije. One of his friends died. It was one of his friends' spring morning. While Thomas was waiting at the station, he had some children from the local school talking about a new wildlife park which is happening soon on Shadow. They never saw it. That little one is closing, said a little girl sadly. Cheer up, said one of the boys who was with her. It would be much better than her. It's curving to have lions and tigers and even a hippo. What's a hippo? Thomas asked curiously. You'll soon see, said his driver. You never know. You may even have to carry some of the animals to the park ourselves, ready for the opening. Thomas is very pleased at this. And very excited. He wondered if he would be allowed to carry the hippo, but he was never sure if he could carry such a special animal. Before long, the animals began to arrive. Some came by lorry to the wildlife park, but some also came by rail. Thomas and the other engines waited ever excitedly to find out which animals they would be carrying. They worked ever hard, pulling extra trains to transport the different animals. The giraffe couldn't fit into a cattle truck, so he'd have a special wagon built for him instead. They had to make sure that he did not travel under any low bridges because of his ever long neck. Everyone let the elephants. They swung their trunks and trumpeted loudly as they clambered up the ramps into their trucks. All the engines here excited about unusual cargo of animals. The next morning, Thomas's driver was extra happy. He whistled as he clambered into the driver's seat. Are you so cheerful today? Asked Thomas. We're curving to the harbour today to collect something for the wildlife park. It hurt Thomas. Isn't that exciting? Thomas peeped his whistle in agreement. I wonder what it could be, Thomas thought quietly. Maybe it was a hippo. And he still wasn't hippish. At the harbour, an enormous crate awaited them. Thomas heard a very curious meowing noise coming from the crate. It wasn't a hippo. Oh no, it was something else. What's inside? Thomas asked his driver. It's a tiger and a cub, explained. The tiger had come all the way by boat from a zoo aboard. A crane ever gently lifted the crate onto the truck. They didn't want to scare them. Special cargo. Thomas's driver made sure that the crate was securely in place on the truck, and Thomas set off ever carefully and ever gently, chuffing through the countryside with his precious load. Shh, 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 shh. It doesn't want to bump it, this special alert. At the big station, Thomas waited patiently while the big crate was unloaded. Careful, Bert, said the foreman to the forklift driver. There's a big kit in there, you know. And it's certainly the biggest kit basket I've ever seen, exclaimed the forklift driver. He didn't realize that the foreman was talking about a tiger. The forklift truck trundled off with the crate to load it onto the back of the lorry. The tiger and a cub's children would be carrying the rest of the way, I wrote. Poor Thomas was ever set at the tiger cub. He'd been ever proud to carry such a noble and beautiful animal, and she was certainly one of the most unusual loads he'd ever transported. I wonder if I shall see her again, Thomas said to his driver. You will one day soon, I'm sure of it, said his driver played. Little Branch Lane to the Wildlife Park be open in a day now. Now, near the station, there was a disused engine shed. The shed hadn't been used for ever, long term. The rails to the shed had been taken up short of her, and the track that was left was strewn with weeds and old slippers. The men used it for storing things they did not use ever often. It was full of rusty cans and old machinery. To tell the truth, this shed was used in the 1960s, but this year it was not. It was abandoned for years. Some sheds had and engines in there and was never found. The windows were broken, and a spider made a huge web round the funnel of an old engine. People rarely visited the shed at all, except for odd occasions when they might be in search of spare parts. Later, when Thomas was passing the shed, he thought he saw something moving inside it. It looked ever strapper, but he didn't realize the truth. It was a tiger in there. Well, Thomas already knew it was a tiger. It was hiding in there. It's strange, Thomas thought to himself. He'd never seen anything like that before in the earlier shed. He wondered if he should mention it to his driver, but then he decided that it was his eyes playing tricks on him. After it was heavy, dark in the shed, Thomas went on his way. He went on his way to take some trucks full of crates to take to Big City Port by the Star Trucks, inspecting something to take to the other parts of Big City.